The absolute dominance of the Plains Camp males continues in the western sector of Sabi Sand. These two brothers are dominant males of the Nkuhuma Breakaway, Mangeni and Shimungwe Pride. All three prides are raising their offspring, and the future of the youngsters seems to be very bright. The Plains Camp males have chased Kambula males and their sister out of their territory as of recently. It's a clear indication of their strength and confidence. Tumbela male seems to have learned the lesson, and he's kept his distance from the Plains Camp males and their prides. He was attacked a couple of months ago by the dominant males, and now he stays in a small chunk of land away from the trouble. He recently spent some time with the two young Ottawa lionesses who are his daughters. Speaking of the young Ottawas, both lionesses are doing great. It's been more than a year since they're on their own, and despite the odds stacked against them, they've done a phenomenal job. Just like their father, they're keeping a low profile to avoid any sort of conflict, as it's their only option. The Black Dam males, who successfully took over a significant territory of their own in northern Sabi Sand last year, have now completely taken over the Nkuhuma Pride. At the start of their reign, everyone thought that nobody would be challenging these two aggressive brothers in the foreseeable future, but the Kambula males have shown some resistance. These four brothers, along with their sister, moved into northern Sabi Sand a couple of months ago and began to roar in the Black Dam-controlled area. Spent some time with the Nkuhuma Pride lionesses. As of lately, they've taken a step back and are now staying at a distance, most likely due to fearing conflict with the bigger and more experienced Black Dam males. The upcoming months will be very interesting, as the Kambula males are likely to challenge a coalition for the control of a significant territory of their own. Whether they choose the Black Dam males as their opposition or they shift their attention to someone else, we'll wait and see. The reign of the last northern Avoca ended last year when Black Dam males moved in, and he wisely moved away along with his four sons. Even though he's visited the Nkuhuma Pride on multiple occasions, he never stays for long due to the looming threat of an attack by the Black Dam males. With him turning 11 years old this year, it's clear that he's not willing to take a chance against these fitter and younger males. Recent reports suggest that Mohawk, along with his four sons, has moved south in Kruger Park. Let's hope they stay safe wherever they go. After the demise of their dominant Mbali male, the Talamati Breakaway Pride has been suffering. Only three of them are left, and they're often found roaming all over the reserve looking very thin. Let's hope they make it through this rough patch. Over in the central Sabi Sand, Nzenga males have completed their 2 years in this area. Even though they're down to two from four, they're still a force to be reckoned with, and their presence provides much-needed stability to the Kambula Pride that's raising a lot of youngsters. Recently, one of the Nzengas sensed the presence of the nomadic Skoro male and went straight for him. The Skoro male luckily became aware in time and managed to sneak away. This incident is a clear testament to the strength of the dominant force that rules over the central Sabi Sand. The nomadic Skoro male spent a very eventful past few weeks. First, he was seen in the company of the Salala lioness, and the pair spent a couple of days mating. Then he formed a brief alliance with the nomadic Nkuhuma male, and they both even chased Kambula males at one point. As Nkuhuma male does as of lately, he left Skoro male and went his own way toward the southern Sabi sand. Skoro male then had a run-in with the Nzinga male that I mentioned earlier. What this young male does in the upcoming weeks, we'll see. After losing his brother, territory, and prides back in August, last southern Avoca has kept a low profile. He's spending his days in the southern Sabi sand away from the attention of any dominant males. His task of surviving during this nomadic phase is a lot harder than his northern brother, who has four sons by his side. Let's hope this legendary lion manages to keep his distance from any threat. The Ankulu males, who took control of the area that was held by southern Avocas, are expanding their territory. These young brothers inevitably came in contact with the neighboring Gijima males. Gijima males got aware of their presence and moved straight towards them. As soon as they realized that they were heavily outnumbered, they ran back quickly, and the young Nkulus gave chase. Fortunately, both coalitions went their own ways without any conflict, but chances of a potential clash are always present. For now, the Nkulus are happy with what they have, and the Gijimas are busy with their own prides. Let's hope they stay off of each other's radars.